This episode is brought to you by my book, Speak From Within. Learn how you can engage, inspire, and motivate any audience. You can also download my 4 simple tips to make starting any conversation a breeze at the link in the show notes. Hello, and welcome to the Creative Solutions Podcast. I'm your host, Izolda Trachtenberg. Whether you're writing the first sentence of a book or solving the climate crisis, to get people's attention, you need to tell your story creatively. On the show, I interview peak performers who are coming up with those creative stories and solutions. Through creativity, compassion, and collaboration, they're changing the world. I also bring you ideas and techniques to unlock your potential to do the same. And now, let's get to the show. Hey there, welcome to the Creative Solutions Podcast bonus episode with Dr. Donte Vaughn of CultureWorx. Donte, thank you for making yourself available to do these fun little bonus questions. Are you ready?
I am ready.
All right, cool. So first question is, what's your favorite song?
Wow, my favorite song. I have so many. I would say Dancing in September by Earth, Wind & Fire.
Oh, as in, do you remember that one? I love that song. Such a great song.
September.
It was always interesting to me that the chorus of that song, Maurice White talked about it and he said, yeah, actually, those are nonsense words. They're because I kept trying to figure out what those lyrics were, and no, they're nonsense words. So, but it's phenomenal. I love the song. It's a great song. All right. So, next question: favorite musical group.
These are hard.
I know. you can do more than one. That's fine.
Okay. So, favorite musical group. I mean, I love music from the 60s, 70s, 80s. I would say the Temptations, just because they've evolved so many different ways all the way through even now to some extent. I would say another favorite group, just because just growing up in my era, everybody wanted to have like a boy group, a boy band. I love R&B. So I would say Boys to Men, especially being from Philly, being from Philly.
Great. Both Boys to Men and the Temptations are both great. Awesome. Next, favorite artist. Does not have to be fine artist. Can be something else. Whatever you define as artist.
Favorite artist. Oh, that's so hard. Oh, my goodness. I would say my favorite artist. I am, I'm a big music fan in general. I'm a self-taught musician. I sing.
Awesome.
So I tend to think of artistry in the context of music. So I'm still going to stay in the music realm and say one of my favorite balladeers and writers of many of his own songs and things, he's deceased now, was actually, I'm a big R&B fan, so I would say Luther Vandross.
Luther Vandross. Yes. And what a voice. What a voice.
I don't think we've had anyone to mirror that in this generation or decade.
So much of his music, it just touched you on the deepest levels. I'm a singer also, so I completely understand where you're coming from. And Teddy Pendergrass, another one from that era, Teddy. Beautiful. Yeah. That era. But then I'm also a fan, like gigantic fan of Aretha Franklin and going back to Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald, Coco Taylor,
All of the above for me. And even still now, even when I think about living legends and their fleeting, which is scary, right? With Aretha and many others. But I even like the Anita Bakers of the world.
Hey, I love Anita Baker for sure.
Patti LaBelle's of the world, but it's scary because it's like, who? These are legends, right?
Yeah.
Replacing them.
Oh, yeah. It's very hard. I mean, Alicia Keys comes kind of close, I guess.
Barely.
But then you know.
We'll see. I mean, that lasting kind of 40 mm-hmm. year, 50 year, 60 year impact on the industry, mm-hmm. it makes me nervous. I love many of the artists out today. I just wonder, will they have that same longevity?
Yeah.
Really touch the soul of people.
Yeah. Yeah. A friend of mine, when I lived in DC, a friend of mine and I saw Eartha Kitt and Nancy Wilson at Blues Alley many times. And when you're talking about that, you know, we were sitting in the front row getting to hear Eartha Kitt sing, "I Want to Be Evil." You cannot, that you can't get past that. That's just, that's wow.
That's an experience that many cannot replicate.
Yeah. And that's the thing. When you see some of these incredible artists, yeah, you and I are of a mind there for sure. That whole era of music, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, but the people who just had that, as you put it, longevity, there. And I hope that we'll see some of the artists of today have that kind of impact and longevity. But I agree with you. I'm waiting to see, you know.
Waiting to see. I mean, yeah. You have a lot of potential, you know, so we'll see.
Yeah, fingers crossed. All right, so now let's move on, because otherwise we're just going to talk about music the whole time. The book you recommend most to people?
Besides my own.
Well, there is that.
You know, I like From Good to Great. I like Strength Finders. I like things that can help an individual realize their greatest potential.
Mm.
I believe our existence in this world, in this physical body, is to help uplift or aid others in some capacity. When we think about the ecosystem of our world, every living thing on this earth serves a function and a purpose beyond itself. And I think the minute we move thinking that our existence is solely to aid or feed ourselves alone, I think we're missing, that's a very lonely proposition. Mm. Right. So any book I would say that helps an individual realize their greatest self potential and the impact of other people's lives, then I'm all for referring it.
Mm. Yeah. No, that makes a lot of sense. And now another music question. What was your first concert?
Wow. I wasn't a huge concert person. So it was more of just the environment and the anxiety of it. I just was like, then I started to grow to like them. And if I recall, my first concert was, Common, the rapper.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a concert that was a promotional, it was like a concert when I was a freshman in college. That was the first time I actually went to a conference. Then the one other one I remember that was relatively around the same time was early in his career, a John Legend concert.
Ooh,
and
early in his career.
Featured, and he actually, this is before she was this big, Alicia Keys, ironically.
Oh, wow.
Early. So it was a John Legend and Alicia Keys concert. I remember that.
Wow, that's great. That's great. I think I'm a little older than you are. My first concert was David Bowie.
That's fair.
Oh no!
David Bowie is again a legend. I mean, rest in peace. But yep,
absolutely. Yeah. Oh, absolutely. I am a big concert goer, especially when you can get a more intimate show like at Blues Alley. That's the best. All right, favorite city.
I have to go with Philly. I mean, I was born and raised in Philly. I mean, I love my city. I reside outside of Atlanta now. I travel all around the U.S. So as many cities I enjoy, from Nashville to Chicago to Vancouver, right? I mean, I'm all over.
Mm-hmm.
However, there's something special or magical about going back to my own city and just the energy and the vibe. When we talk about the city of brotherly love, even in its own challenges, I still enjoy my own city.
That's awesome. I love that. I, as I said, I'm an immigrant. I haven't been to where I was born since we left, but it is so, it's so cool to hear that your home is your home. And my younger sister actually resides right outside Atlanta, and that area is, it's happening though. It's got a lot going on. So I like coming down and visiting Atlanta because it is,
yeah,
there's so much, there's a lot going on.
It's one of the fastest growing metro cities in America,
Yeah.
and there's a lot to offer. Having grown up so long in the city and what have you, as I'm raising my son and my wife and I decided, hey, we want to live outside the city. So we live in a suburb north of Atlanta, but from what I've experienced in my couple years here thus far, it's a great city as well.
Yeah, no, I really like Atlanta, and my sister lives on the southwest side of Atlanta, but it's the biggest airport in the world is Atlanta, which you wouldn't think, but it is.
It
Fascinating.
is.
All right, backpack, wallet, rucksack, or purse?
And I'm wallet first, and then what I've been finding myself doing, especially with a toddler, is I carry a small like messenger bag for when I need to carry some extra stuff. But I'm wallet. I've been carrying a wallet since I was probably 10. I mean, when wallets were still a thing, I still carry a wallet.
Yeah, I wish that I could just have a wallet. I find I'm with a big, huge backpack everywhere I go, no
Now
matter what.
I carry a backpack behind you. See, there's a backpack sitting in that chair because I'm still kind of old school and I like files. I like things that feel tangible, especially when I'm traveling. If there's internet failure and stuff like that, I want to be able to get what I need. So yeah.
Yeah, and my laptop is with me, so it's always a big backpack and my laptop and all the things I'm going to need for the day. I live in New York City, so I'm out and about all the time, and you can't always get, even though it's the biggest city, can't always get what you need right then. All right, two more little questions. Cookie, favorite cookie.
I'm gonna have to go with oatmeal raisin is my number one, and probably chocolate chip number two.
You know what's interesting about that is that of the hundreds of people I have asked this question, all but five, you being number six now, have said chocolate chip as the number one answer. You are one of three people who has said oatmeal raisin. I'm
Yeah, I know a
keeping.
lot of people don't like oatmeal raisin. I'm like, y'all sleeping. Maybe you haven't had a good one, but no, I love oatmeal raisin for some reason. I just
No,
love
hey, you know what you know. But it is interesting to me how many people love chocolate chip and how few people say oatmeal raisin. A couple of people have said sugar cookies, but really it seems to be chocolate chip is the answer. But you three who have said oatmeal raisin, yay. All right. Now the last question is a three-part question, and that is your favorite book as a child, your favorite book as a teenager, and your favorite book as an adult.
Green Eggs and Ham. Fences, which is actually, I think I think the screenplay was after the book. Fences. And then as an adult, I read more self-help kind of things. And I'm gonna go, oh, don't sweat the small stuff. And it's all small stuff. I forget the author's name at the top of my head, but it's
Yeah,
called
and I know the book. Awesome. That was great. Thank you so much, Dante. This has been such a fun bonus episode and such a terrific conversation earlier. I'm super grateful you took the time, and I know you've got to go. We could keep chatting music the whole for the next 6 hours, I have a feeling, but I know you've got a day to get back to. Thank you again for joining me. I really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, Izolda. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate you being here. Please subscribe to the podcast if you're new, and it would mean the world to me if you told a friend about it. Today's episode was produced by Izolda Trachtenberg and is copyright 2023. As always, please remember this is for educational and entertainment purposes only. Past performance does not guarantee future results, although we can always hope. Until next time, keep living what you believe in.